What is up, my friends, and welcome to another edition of the XFL Week in Review. I'm your host, Mark Perry, editor of XFL News Hub, and on this week's show, Jordan Tamu is back in the NFL, not the XFL, and Taylor Russolino kicks for the Broncos. That didn't go very well, plus the latest player news and so much more. So how do you get in touch with the show? You email podcast at XFL News Hub with your MP3s. Or call 888-430-7692, extension 3. Remember to leave us a review on Apple Podcasts, and we will read it on the show. It's a quick show this week. There's not much going on. So let's take a look at some of the news items for this week. So first up, Lions have signed Battlehawks QB Jordan Tamu to the practice squad. Remember, he was on the Kansas City Chiefs for a while there. Then he was cut 2 months ago. Now he is back on the practice squad for the Lions, I assume for the rest of the season. Not sure he'll get any playing time. Matthew Stafford, they were worried about him, that he might be out, but he's back in, so no worries there. But I think he could stick on at least till the end of the season. Battlehawks kicker Taylor Russolino debuted for the Denver Broncos this past Saturday, and according to the stat sheet, all of us XFL fans were super excited about to see him, thinking he was the real deal, somebody that totally deserved a shot. And basically, he was 0-for-1 and 1-for-3 on extra points. It just did not do well. It did not go well for Taylor Russolino. Maybe he'll get another shot. He was re-signed back to the practice squad, so he's not gone yet. However, that was not a good showing. That was the kicker that all of us in the XFL world thought that was the best kicker in the XFL. 31 years old, deserves a shot, got his shot. I mean, the winds were really bad in Denver. I mean, 20-mile-an-hour winds, but came up short. 0-for-1 and 1-for-3 on extra points. That's not good. But we'll see what happens. Season is far from over. Other kicker who didn't do too well, but then Sergio Castillo, he had a bad week, got cut, but then got re-signed to the Jets practice squad. Had a couple good games, but his last game, he missed 3 field goals in the Jets 40-3 loss to the Seattle Seahawks. Jets won this past weekend, so maybe all is well there. So he's back. And also, one other tidbit of news, the Spring League finally had their championship game. The winners were the Generals of the 2020 Spring League Championship. They beat the Aviators 37-14. Congratulations to all of them. 4 weeks in, a lot of little drama going on with the TSL, the Spring League, but they were finally to get the game in, got a chance to watch some of it. Again, it was good football. I'm really curious to see where the Spring League goes from here. That's really it for the news this week. Let's get to some commercials, see what's going on in the XFL Markcast, and then we'll get to your social media stuff right after this. Stay tuned.
Here's what you missed last week on the XFL Markcast.
Should we plug our big interview before we get into all the XFL stuff? I don't want to bury the lead.
Let's not bury the lead. Yes, we got Brian Scott coming up. Brian Scott,
MVP of the Spring League. I really appreciate he said, you know, I'm sure phone's blowing off the hook, social media stuff. I really appreciate it. You know, Brian, he's still in his hotel room down in Orlando, you know, just won the big Spring League.
There was a lot of stuff that happened with the TSL prior to this. Were you concerned that this championship wasn't going to happen? And
you know, I'm a big believer in Brian Woods. I think Brian Woods has done a great job. You know, he had talked to me and just kind of asked me if he thought that we could get the Generals to come back. And you know, I took that, you know, upon myself, and I kind of wanted that challenge to try and get all the guys to come back. And so that was for the last 2 weeks or ever long after we left San Antonio. I think a lot of guys really weren't sure if we were going to play or had that same mindset that you guys think, where it's like, hey, I don't think there's going to be a championship game. But in my mind, you know, being just who I am, I knew there was going to be a championship game.
What's the issue here? What's really the issue that Vince is getting at?
Well, yeah, there's got to be something on there, some data or something on the phone that Oliver Luck doesn't want him to see, right? I mean, if it was squeaky.
Like a text message?
Well, I don't know. I mean, you would think at this point I would have formatted that phone. I would have thrown it in the.
It's a crazy thing, but the statute that they're fighting over right now does not give any type of rights to a former employer to have the passcode. If he was still employed by by Alpha, it would be a completely different scenario. But you know, again, you know, it's kind of just a little back and forth between these guys. Vince didn't want to end up having to pay everything that he owed to Oliver, so he did what he had to do.
Very early Christmas, you filthy animals. Because this will be after Christmas, right?
No. Oh, my gosh.
Isn't Christmas on... What day is Christmas?
Oh, Christmas is on Friday.
It'll be on Christmas. I didn't even realize.
Yeah, that's what I kept telling you. Are you not listening to me?
Well,
I
thought it'd be like the day after. Okay. Well, there you go.
We're not editing this out.
No, that's fine.
Of course, you could find XFL Markcast on XFL News Hub and wherever you get podcasts, including YouTube.
What's up, XFL Army? If you're a fan of the XFL News Hub and you have a telephone, which I know all of you do because you're sitting there playing on your phones all the time, then why not download the XFL News Hub app? That's right, it's on iTunes. It's on Android. We have an Android version and an iPhone version of the XFL News Hub app. So what do you get? You get the latest news from XFL News Hub, the premier source of XFL news in the universe. Plus, you get push notifications when we have breaking news. You will be the first to know. You can leave a comment on some of the news right from your phone. Plus, you get this podcast on your phone as well. Remember, you can leave us reviews on the Google Play Store or iTunes. It links to other social media, our other social media accounts, and so much more. Be in the know. I know you're on your phones. People are on their phones all the time. They never get off their phones. So why not just download the XFL News Hub app on your Android or iPhone today? All you need to do is go to the Google Play Store or iTunes and just type in XFL News Hub. That's XFL News Hub. Download our app on your phone today. All right, let's hit the social media stuff. First, the Lions signing Jordan Taihamu. Trevor says, I wish he was still on my practice squad. I think he's talking about the Kansas City Chiefs. They are looking good as another run for Super Bowl. But it was good to see Jordan sign with the team, especially one that there's an outside shot of playing versus there's like no chance of playing or getting any kind of run with the Kansas City Chiefs. So on to the YouTubes. Old School Boxing Talk says, thanks for covering these guys. I want to know more about them. Talking about Major League Football announcing their spring league. We talked about that last week. Jack, tier one mailer messenger from says, nice. Thank you very much. Us Soldiers channel says, if MLFB is publicly traded company, why can't I buy shares of them on Webull or Robinhood? That's a good question. Ray Weir says, looks like they're listed OTC, which means Ameritrade or E-Trade. Webull and Robin doesn't trade OTC stock. That's where, hey, thanks for Ray Weir for answering that question, because that is US Soldiers, that's a good, both are good questions, where you can trade that stock. BMN says, these new leagues are destined to fail. The XFL is going to be huge again. I agree with that. You got your call football. You got Major League Football. We'll see what happens. We'll just keep an eye on that. And we'll keep you up to date, see what's going on. But the king of spring football is the XFL, and they'll be back in 2022. Fear the Greek Freak says, just bought 7 XFL shirts and a hat for myself for Christmas. Got to support. That's what I'm talking about. Yes, you do have to support. XFL had a final like Christmas sale, like 60% off on a bunch of stuff on merch, and got to buy that stuff. Got to support the league. Mr. John Ackerman says, I was signed to the MLFB for its first season and they canceled days prior to camp. Hope these younger guys get a platform to play the game they love. I think they had issues. That was like 2017? Oh, yeah, you get to see me with my glasses on while I'm reading this stuff. 2017, I think, was when they were going on with that deal, where that had issues with the Major League Football, I think. Who knows? But thanks for the message. Creep of O'Freak says, talking about Major League Football, says, love it, would love to see football played year-round. Also says, I made a video about the NFL year-round, but I really don't care who plays in the spring or summer as long as there's football. Okay. John Henry Schneider talking about relocation in the XFL. LA to Salt Lake City. Seattle to Portland. Why? Dallas to OKC. Not necessary. Houston to Austin. Not necessary. New York, stay in a small venue. Okay, DC, stay. Oh, thank you. DC gets to stay. Tampa to Alabama or Mississippi. That's the only one I would say, the Tampa one, but that's Orlando. Thanks for the messages, but none of that's going to happen. I think they're going to stay wherever. Everywhere, I think they're going to stay. I don't think anybody's moving whatsoever. And finally, Gloria Lopez says, I have patience for the love of football, XFL, Houston Roughnecks. A shout out to Danny Garcia and The Rock. Keep up the great work. Looking forward to some great football in the future. Love y'all. We love them too, and we love Gloria as well. And we love all y'all that listen to the XFL Week in Review, XFL Markcast, and hanging out on XFL News Hub. We love you guys, man. So nothing but love from your boys here in XFL News Hub. On the Instagram, there was this Space Force announced that they were going to be called the Guardians. This is what our vice president put out there. He was part of that kind of thing. So we put a little thing out and said, which Guardians is better? The Space Force Guardians, which, I mean, just terrible. Or the New York Guardians. XFL underscore fanatic says, love the Guardians, but my Face Force has to be my pick. I love the whole space thing. I just think you could make it cooler and you could sell more merch when it comes to it. But I'm all about space exploration. Totally need to do it. I hate those people that are like, hey, you're wasting your money. Like half of the things, cellular phones and microwaves and so much technology that we use today is because of the space program. So I'm all for space program. But, you know, maybe we'll change the name from Space Force to something else and maybe the Guardians to something else as well. Maybe the Vipers. How about Space Force Vipers? There you go. Your friend Mark just figured it out. On the Twitter, talking about the Guardians thing, at Pimlico Bandit says, the one on the right, I'd prefer Roughnecks, LOL. All right, Roughnecks fans, no question there. And XFLPLS4061 says, I find it hard to believe they're stealing the Star Trek symbol and trying to use an XFL trademark. This administration is truly pathetic. Sorry to get political. I hear you. I hear you, my friend, on that one as well. We appreciate everybody checking in on the social media stuff. Quiet week. Christmas time, however, the XFL did put out a little Christmas message for everybody out there, which I thought was nice of them. So making the holidays bring your warmth and happiness. Cheers to 2021. This is from the XFL on their official Twitter and all their social media stuff. So it was nice to see the XFL putting something out there for the holidays. It's been a quiet week. It's going to be a quiet, I'm hoping January we start to, I wonder if the XFL is just kind of letting the NFL have its time. It's towards the end of the NFL season. Let their kind of have their due. NBA is going to kick in. Hopefully we start to get some stuff in January and February from the XFL, even just something. Who the commissioner is going to be. There's been rumors out there. We don't have anything corroborated because we don't report on rumors here at XFL News Hub, even though we got some. So just have to kind of wait and see what happens. But hey, from your boy Mark, enjoy your Christmas holiday. Stay safe out there, my friends. Oh, and before we go, remember, if you want to be part of the show, podcast XFL News Hub with your MP3s or videos, or call 888-430-7692 extension 3. Leave us a review on Apple Podcasts. We'll read it on the show. Remember, you can follow us everywhere on the Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, the whole deal. Download our app. Plus, you can listen to us everywhere at xflnewshub.com/xfl-podcast. For show notes, and then you can join us on the Discord, hanging out, talking fantasy, talking. One thing about the fantasy, which are getting closer to that January 4th launch for the pro wrestling side of things as a test bed. But one of the things I think I'm going to do is in August, if you're interested, in August, I would like to run through the XFL. So I want to do it before the XFL draft happens, but I want to run through, simulate the XFL season. So the 2020 XFL season, have a draft with real people, you guys out there, eight teams. We do a draft, and then each week we set the lineup. The data goes into the system, calculates the points, and just kind of run, give it like a dry run in August of the XFL, so that when if we get a draft and we get some kind of roster movement coming in October, we have the draft, we have rosters, we can start filling stuff out, so that maybe come, you know, December timeframe, when we kind of get those rosters finalized, you guys could start doing some drafts a year from now. So that was kind of the idea I had going on there. So if you want to be part of that, join us on the Discord and you can learn more about what's going on. But that's way down. I want to get this rolled out, calculating. It's working now. It's emailing and tracking errors and all sorts of stuff. So it's looking good for that January 4th launch for wrestling fans. But again, that's the first piece of the puzzle. That works. It works fine. We go through a couple iterations. Then you have the software ready to go for an XFL season in 2022 with fantasy, which was kind of there before, but it didn't work for me. I thought I could do better, and we'll see. I'll put up or shut up. I got a year to prove it. So that's it for me, folks. Again, have a great Christmas. Enjoy your time. Stay safe out there, my friends. Don't get you know what, so we can get through this, because I am so looking forward to the spring. I bought golf clubs. I'm going to play some golf this spring to kind of get out. I'm looking, just get past January, February, the suckiest months of the year, and at least in our northeastern part of the United States here in Maryland, because snow and cold. I like the spring, and Maryland is fantastic, and getting into that summer, because not only will the weather be better, hopefully things will be safer, and also we'll get to get more XFL stuff. Could you imagine hanging out at an XFL training camp or something like that, or an open practice or a tryout or something like that come this summer? That would be fantastic. So that's it, my friends. We'll be back next week. Stay safe. Enjoy the Christmas holidays and any holiday you're celebrating over this past month, wherever you are, because we are worldwide and we welcome everybody to the XFL community. So that's it for me, folks. God bless. Stay safe, and I will see you all later.